Hey everyone, and welcome to Sketching with Sarah. I'm Sarah, and in today's video, I'm going to walk you through my Mermay 2020 Week 4 drawings. I'll be sharing some of my storytelling I created with art in these Mermay prompts. I'll also be showing you some of my character designing and introduce you to a new character that I included in this Mermay 2020 narrative series. Stick around to the end of this video where I'll be sharing some of my exciting plans for my Mermay series. So let's get right into Mermay Week 4. Day 22 is ablaze. In my last Mermay video, I talked about the surrounding drawing with the Porky Puffer and Hedgerfish, roasting marshmallows on a campfire, and with this ablaze prompt, I decided to add to it by adding my Octafin into my series because he is an ocean character and why not? Also, since octopi are really intelligent, this Octafin isn't really buying the whole fire underwater situation, and he just really doesn't get why it's ablaze because they're underwater. He's probably not complaining though, I mean, who doesn't love roasted marshmallows? Day 23 is Mermay prompt is Siren Song. So for those of you that don't know, sirens are mythical creatures who live in the water, and they have beautiful melodic voices and are very, very beautiful in their appearance as well, and they use that to lure men in as their prey. So I thought I would use the Starbucks siren logo because Starbucks has that same pull on people, I think. So I was gonna try and simplify that Starbucks logo, but then I got pretty lazy and I just decided to make a couple music notes instead. And I think by doing that, it makes the prompt a little more prevalent because siren song and a music note directly ties to each other. So I decided to stick with that for the logo. But I feel like since it's still a circle logo with white detail and it's also on a cup like that with a green straw, I think it's pretty clear that it's about Starbucks. So here's my sea goose character falling victim to this sweet melody. Day 24 is treasure. In my sketchbook tour and in Inktober, I used my Bassam, which is a possum bat hybrid. I used that Bassam character a lot when there was any kind of stolen treasure or treasure in general, because those characters in particular are very sneaky and stealthy. But for this one, I decided to have my Octafin snooping around this time. I'm really excited to redraw this one digitally for my series, so I can play with the colors and the shininess and the sparkles and just the way that the light bounces off of everything, I think will be really fun to play around with. So look forward to that. Day 25's prompt is shark. So for this one, I decided to make a new hybrid that is mashed with the shark. I love hammerhead sharks and hamsters, and I think it worked out perfectly to mix them because the puffy cheeks on the hamster is just so perfect with the hammerhead eyes. And as I was creating him, I was like, oh my God, what have I done? But as I continue to draw him, I kind of love him. He grew on me for sure. Also, he loves peanuts, so that's a fun fact. Day 26 is shore. So when I saw this prompt, I honestly thought it was kind of lame, so I changed to snore instead, not only for it to be more entertaining for me to figure out what to draw with that, but I also was really pumped about my hamster head shark, and I wanted to milk him for another prompt as far as I could. So in this drawing, he's snoozing after overfeeding himself with peanuts. He's got a little drool mark there. So cute. Day 27 is punk. So here we are back with my Porky Puffer and his spiky punk rock gear. I'm also really excited to rework this idea digitally too, so I can mess with the composition and where he is on the stage or in the crowd and how all of the show lights bounce around and all the colored lights and things like that. I think it would be really fun to play around with digitally. So I'm very excited to see what I can come up with this character. Also, when I posted this to Instagram, I got asked what his favorite band is, and it's hands down Green Day. So that's a little fun fact about Porky Puffer. Day 28's prompt is bestial. So I had to add my Hedgerfish to the punk show, and he went a little crazy and arrived late, and apparently he was pre-gaming quite a bit, so he did show up to that venue pretty wild. I do want to remind everyone that I am doing Mermay as an exercise to stretch my creativity in the concepts of the drawings. Rather than focusing on making a pretty painting every day, I'm doing this mostly to avoid burnout and keep pressure low so I don't get discouraged to keep going. I hate it when I start to dread doing the next prompt each day. I feel like that's why every time I tried Inktober before last year, I just started with this expectation to make this beautiful ink drawing every single day. Because I put that pressure on myself to make it beautiful and detailed and complex. It ultimately made me kind of dread wanting to do it every day because I put that high expectation on myself. And it started to make me feel like, oh, now I gotta do another Inktober today. Or gosh, I forgot to do an Inktober today. I guess I gotta do that now, you know. Just an overall not excited attitude towards it at all. So when I decided to let go of that pressure in this past Inktober and created an animal hybrid inspired by each prompt, it actually got me really excited to do each prompt because it was no longer about the end result. If you've ever struggled with doing a long-term art challenge like this, I would encourage you to find something that you really, really love drawing, like say that be girls or frogs or cars or really anything that you really just enjoy drawing. It could even be flowers if you wanted it to. And use the prompts to inspire how you draw that flower or where that flower is, or really try and stretch your imagination to make the prompt fit what you like to draw. And that's kind of what I did with animals for Inktober. If you're interested to see my Inktober from last year, I'll link my sketchbook tour playlist in the description, and that has all of them there, so feel free to check that out if you're interested. I came up with some pretty cool hybrids that I ended up using for actual illustrations. So that's just another cool thing that when you're really excited about stuff every day, like I was for creating the drawings for each Inktober Day prompt, some of my best creative works kind of came out of it when I took that pressure off of me. And because I was so excited about what I just created, it made me want to make more about it and use those characters into a full illustration. It inspired me to do other things with them as well. So you never know what could come out of drawing every single day. Now for some exciting news. With these drawings, as I draw them digitally and I start to work on them, I'm thinking of making a mini booklet or something. Something that binds them all together so you can see them all at once, or that you can flip through and see them all in one physical thing. I'm not sure the layout of that yet, or I might end up even making a story about them. I don't really know. But since I have all these drawings and I will be making them all more polished in a digital version, I really want to try and make something with them. I'm also playing with the idea of making a Patreon, and I am so open to suggestions as far as give outs. I could do monthly stickers or monthly buttons or pins. I can post line art or some exclusive tutorials based on what you guys want. Another idea that I had is when I hit a milestone on my Instagram followers or here on YouTube, I would take the first 10 or so maybe, or 20, I don't know, and I'll do like quick doodles of two of your favorite animals combined. I think that's a really fun way to kind of get to know you guys and make a cute, fun little doodle for you guys. Plus it's your two favorite animals, so you can't not like it, right? I tried to do this in the past with some of my friends and their favorite animals, and I had a lot of fun doing it, and honestly, I could have done that all day. And I think that would be a fun thing to do on Patreon as well. All of my patrons get their own two favorite animals combined from me, and a little sketch or doodle or something that I can send to them. I think that'd be super cool. So let me know if you would be interested in that, because that in itself isn't incentive enough for me to make a Patreon, because I just would enjoy doing those. But let me know if that's something you guys would be interested in. I would love to hear what you guys have to say. I'll be reworking these drawings on my Twitch streams. So if you don't already, please follow me on there at twitch.tv/sketchingwithsarah and on my other socials so you can be alerted when I go live so you don't miss it. All that's linked in the description too. While you're down there, I also have all the supplies I used in this video, as well as some links to some other videos I think you might enjoy or that I mentioned in this video. If you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and comment what you think. What would you want as a patron of mine? Do you think it would be cool to have an animal hybrid of your two favorite animals? I also want to know which of these characters in this week's Mermay is your favorite and why. As always, I love to hear what you have to say, and feel free to drop in some feedback as well so that I can keep making these videos better and better. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Apparently he was pre-graming, wow. Oh god.